Meanwhile, Koboko Municipality Mayor Sanya Wilson has lashed out at Uganda Revenue Authority officials in Moyo, accusing them of landing the drivers recently shot dead in South Sudan into trouble. He says this is because officials' demand for exorbitant amounts of money, drivers are forced to use insecurity routes to Juba. Government of Uganda has tasked South Sudan to check its insecurities. We have more.
District officials in Koboko say the drivers are charged between 500,000 to 1 million shillings by URA officials in Moyo. This is deemed unfair since most of these drivers transact businesses with very little capital. Ivan Kakairi, the Asua region manager URA, regretted the killings of the drivers in South Sudan and has promised to investigate some of his offices over allegations of demanding for bribes from drivers.
And with you and the families, accept our sincere condolences. If mayor allows, I'll come and he allows me visit the families of the grieved. Here, grief with you. We stand with you, and I'm coming to Koboko myself. The mayor will give me the day, and I'll be in Koboko with you to demystify this problem. I'll give him my number. He's going to give me his number. Don't fear to call me.
Five bodies of Ugandans who were killed in South Sudan yesterday arrived at a Lego border. They were received from Nimule by a delegation from Uganda led by Asua Regional Police Commander SP Kaije Steven at the No Man Land along Uganda-South Sudan border amidst security deployment from both sides. The five bodies brought Uganda in a South Sudan ambulance and a NOAA in a convoy of 17 vehicles, include those of the four drivers that were killed on Sunday. Meanwhile, the other body is of a border operator and a resident of Terego District who died in an alleged motor accident in Juba. The bodies were transferred to Uganda at Elegu, where they were escorted to Koboko by a team of over 30 vehicles and countless motorcycles ferrying mourners. They were offloaded for post-mortem at Koboko Hospital. According to coordinated information from the security team, the bodies of the four truck drivers thought to be from Uganda Central Region were all recovered by South Sudan forces and taken to Juba awaiting clearance before returning them to Uganda. Meanwhile, the Asua Region Police Commander advised Ugandans not to blame the entire South Sudan government for the killings, saying the practice is only done by a few wrong elements.
Let's not blame the government of South Sudan. These activities are done by individuals. They're not done by government. We already know that we have more bodies remaining the other side, so we still have a long way to go. So we are going to continue working to see that the other bodies come, but also to work with our counterparts to see that these things don't continue happening.
Main streets in Koboko Municipality were lit up by a section of protesters, mainly young people, demanding to observe the bodies of the deceased. They burnt vehicle tires, particularly at Koboko Main Roundabout and along Koboko Moyo Road. The bodies were later taken to their respective families for burial. Authorities have, however, advised Ugandans not revenge on innocent Sudanese living in Uganda. Meanwhile, government through the Minister of Foreign Affairs has, in the strongest terms possible, condemned the reckless murders of Ugandans in South Sudan. The government of Uganda has further appealed to government of South Sudan to restore security along routes from the Ugandan border points into Juba to facilitate safe movement of persons, goods and services. In the meantime, the government of Uganda advises its nationals to exercise extreme caution as they travel to South Sudan. They should note that violent crimes such as carjackings, stoppings, ambushes, assaults, robberies and kidnappings have taken place in South Sudan, particularly the Oraba Kaya Ya Juba Road. The government extends heartfelt condolences and sympathy to the families of the victims of the attack at these difficult times. That was from a statement from the Minister of Foreign Affairs in relation to the shootings in South Sudan.